All right, so today we're gonna be talking about, is being a freight broker all it's cracked up to be? Because I've seen so many people want to get in this industry over the last couple of years. I wanted to make this video and talk about some of the negative things and a lot of the positive things too, but some of the things that are just a little bit overlooked that maybe companies that you've been interviewing with just don't tell you. And so that is gonna be today's video. What do companies not tell you? And do I really want to be a freight broker? All right, so the first one is work-life balance. I see it all the time where a lot of people come in and then they think that it's going to happen a lot faster for them than what it actually does, than the realistic expectations. So I want to have realistic expectations for everybody watching this video on if you have an idea, if you have this dream of becoming a freight broker, it takes time. There's no shortcut to it. It takes time. Yes. Okay. Let me back up there just a little bit. There are certain things that you can do, different software, different subscriptions that you can have to make the process go faster, but there is no shortcut to the hard work and the effort that you need to put in and the calls that you need to put in. We're going to get into all that, but the work-life balance at the very beginning of being a freight broker is nothing short of terrible. Okay. Have that expectation. My life does not pretty much exist until I have a book of business. That's very, very tough for a lot of people to do, and maybe it's not for you. Maybe you should just stop watching this video right now, because if you think that you're gonna be able to do this for even just 8 hours a day, getting started, 8 hours a day, that's a full work day, it's not. It's just not, okay? When you're getting started, you're making so many calls. And how many calls do you need to make minimum per day to be successful? As many as you can. There is not a number. Stop counting the number, actually. Forget about a number and just keep calling. Just keep perfecting your list and shaping it to get it a little bit better and better. We're gonna dive into all that. But right now, the work-life balance, just straight up, is terrible when you get started. And if you can push yourself through that, if you have the capability, maybe you don't, maybe you're a single parent, maybe you're stay at home, you know, whatever the case is, maybe you're looking for a remote job and you know you have the kids and you have too many responsibilities and picking them up from school and dropping them off. It is unfortunate that those kind of things, you know, would interfere in a way to this, but to be honest with you, it would do you no, it wouldn't be doing you a service. It would be doing you a disservice to give you any other expectation of being a broker at any company and being successful at it. And I just think it would be lying. And so we're not gonna do that. We're gonna tell the truth. Is it unfortunate? It's unfortunate, but it is what it is. There is no life outside of building your book basically for the first 6 months, maybe a year. That depends on you. And it doesn't just depend on you. It also depends on luck, which we'll talk about too. But yeah, terrible at first. Number two, your personal life matters.
What?
What is this guy talking about? Yes, you have no personal life. And then also your personal life matters. Let me tell you what I mean by that. Your support system around you, your family, your friends, you know, for that 1 hour after work each day that you actually get to have a drink with somebody, whatever. Those people that you surround yourself with need to be accepting and supportive of your goals and what you're trying to accomplish and how you're trying to build that book of business. It is extremely difficult. If you don't surround yourself with the right people that are encouraging you to do better and better and that know your goal and always encourage you to do better and reach those goals and to obtain what you're trying to fight for here, it's not gonna work. You need to have supportive people around you or nobody around you while you're doing it, in my opinion. That's the only way that you're gonna be able to focus in on what you need to do. This is tough. There's no way around it. It is tough. In my opinion, it's worth it if it works out for you. I've been doing this a long time. There is a lot of money in it and there's a lot of freedom in it later. But right now, until you get to that point that you're successful, you don't have that luxury. Plain and simple. All right, number three, does it fit your personality? You know, there's so many different personalities out there and this job does really, really well with a combination of two of them. So let's talk about it. Number one, it's gonna be a salesman personality. Of course, whenever you're opening new accounts, if you are aggressive, if you're a salesman, if you're not, you know, afraid of hearing no a million times, you're gonna do better than somebody who's not. You're gonna be picking up the phone, you're gonna be making the dials, putting it down, picking it right back up. The more calls you make, the more opportunity you're going to have. Now, if you are somebody who has a personality that is really good with sales, right? You're a good salesman, then obviously you're gonna be a little bit more persuasive and you're gonna get more accounts than somebody that, you know, maybe isn't quite so good at sales. Doesn't mean that somebody who's not great at sales can't do this job. there's another personality trait that does really well with this as well, and that's customer service. And so with us kind of being on a different spectrum of sales, where we really are trying to find and solve a problem that could arise daily instead of something in 3 years or 5 years, or sell them a car or something like that, you know, we're really trying to get to the root of what their problems are, whatever types of problems that they see on a regular basis, whether it's late trucks or, you know, things with LTL, whatever the case may be. If you have a mindset where you really just want to solve those problems for them, they will be able to hear that on the phone and they might give you a shot. Now, after that, the customer service personality goes much further than the sales personality, because we can get into accounts. A salesman can get into an account, he can open up a customer and he can get a chance. But a good customer service rep, somebody who has good customer service skills, you know, it's just their personality, they can grow an account. They can take it and they can blow it up. Because, you know, I've seen so many different good sales guys that become successful, have successful books of business, that are no longer brokers because they couldn't handle the stresses that arise on successful accounts. Because successful accounts have so much volume. You know, you start doing $8, $10, $15, $20,000 a week in profit, you know, hundreds of thousands of dollars in revenue. And of course, you're going to be getting into different issues that arise weekly. We're talking weekly numbers. So, you know, imagine you're doing, you know, $8,000 in profit a week is somewhere probably close to 60, 70 loads a week. Well, you're gonna have issues. Or maybe it's 50 loads a week, I don't know. You're gonna have issues though, they're gonna arise. And the people who get stressed out about those issues and don't handle the stress right and just they get overwhelmed, they get so frustrated, they never make it here. And so if you're good at customer service and you're patient and you can handle those issues and you can get on the phone with the customer and explain it without escalating the situation, so you're gonna explain the problems without escalating the situation, you can build a very, very successful book. So the mixture of two, the mixture of a good salesman getting into a new account, but also that has those skills of being able to relay the information to a customer the right way without escalating the problem, the patience to deal with the problem and the carriers whenever it arises, the patience and the persistence of following up on the claims or whatever issues it is and making sure that it just gets taken care of while not getting overwhelmed by the situation, that's a person who you will see that'll have a $20,000 a week plus account. So number four is going to be rejection. Listen, you're going to hear no a ton more than you're going to hear yes. I'm just telling you that right now. Do we need to talk about this more? I don't think so. Which brings us to luck. Yes, it does help being persuasive. Yes, it does help having that natural salesman gene, but it doesn't really matter if you can't get somebody on the phone, and that is luck. You know, calling the right person at the right time, it's just lucky. So when you look at that and you see somebody, you know, like, you know, a good salesman can call somebody 50 times and every single one of those times the person's not available, they're out, or maybe they do pick up the phone and they're just not interested and everything's going great. But anybody can call randomly at any time and there'd be a fire going on over at that prospect's plant. Not a literal fire, but an issue. You know, they need help. And calling at the right moment that they actually need help, that's enough to get you in the door. Maybe their other broker just dropped the ball. Something bad just happened. Something urgent is happening right now and they need a truck right now and you just called and they say, you know what? I'm gonna give you a shot. It's your lucky day. Guess what it is? But it's only lucky because you picked up the phone. You get luckier the more calls you make. That's it. It's a numbers game. So yes, while a natural salesperson will be able to close more customers that they get on the phone than someone who maybe doesn't have that natural talent. But like the old saying goes, hard work beats talent when talent refuses to work hard. If the person is just, you know, maybe that natural born salesperson's picking up and making 15 calls a day, 20 calls a day, that's not gonna be enough. It doesn't matter. The odds are against it. You just got to get somebody on the phone and you're not going to ever grow a successful book of business making 15, 20 calls a day, in my opinion. So simply put, you increase your odds when you increase your volume. All right, lastly, to wrap up everything that I basically said is work ethic. Besides, of course, personality traits of being either a little bit more natural salesman or customer service oriented, work ethic is everything. It's what puts it all together. Work ethic is being able to hear no a million times a day, put down the phone, pick it back up, call the next person and not let it bother you and just focus on your goal only. Not focus on whatever answer it is that they give you, but focus on your goal to that yes, that one yes that could change everything for you. One account as a freight broker could be as little as one load a week at maybe a $200 margin or 30 loads a week at $200 margins. $6,000 account. I've seen it so many times. I've actually seen it a ton of times where people get so lucky at the beginning of their careers because they just get lucky first day of making calls. Oh, I got a big account. And that's not always the best thing for them, to be honest, because if they ever go and lose that account, then they're starting over with nothing. And it just gives them this false sense of success because they're not there yet. They didn't work for it. And ultimately, because they got it so easily, they usually don't try as hard or put in the effort of making more calls afterwards to grow that book. And when they lose that one account, they're left with nothing. They're starting over. So it's really nice when somebody works really, really hard for a long time, slow grows the account, gets one customer that gives them a load a week, $200 margin. Another customer gives me a load a week, $200 margin. Then all of a sudden I grow those into two loads a week, $200 margin, right? And then I get another customer. And that person, when they finally do get a big account, they don't take it for granted. So if you are somebody who's starting off as a freight broker and you just got a big account, you're in your first 6 months or a year and you got one big account, do not take that thing for granted. You could lose it at any time. I've lost customers at no fault of my own. Nothing bad happened. I lost a customer because the company was bought out and the company that bought them was in contract with another 3PL. And all of a sudden, they weren't allowed to use me anymore. Nothing that I did, absolutely nothing. We had a great relationship for years and then just gone. And guess what? That account was like a $6,000-$7,000 a week profit account. I did nothing wrong. It can be gone just like that. So don't take any accounts for granted. Keep growing your book of business. So what I'll leave you with is the biggest difference between a successful broker and somebody who's not a successful broker is the work ethic, okay? And putting together all of these things. So somebody who is willing to make 100 calls a day versus somebody who's willing to make 25, it is possible that the guy who's making 25 calls a day does get luckier than you do. It is possible, closes an account or two, but they never win the race, okay? The person who's putting in the most volume and their quality volume, you know, these are quality leads. They're going through and they're finding the best leads that they possibly can. They're not just going on Google and calling people. They're actually making a proper list first and then hitting the call volume. It does take both. You cannot just go on Google and make 100 calls a day and expect it to work out great for you. There are other avenues of pre-qualifying people before actually building your list and making those calls, and that has to be done first. We're not gonna go through that in our call or in this video here. It's something that I do internally at League, and we have our own methods of, you know, building our list, but a good list has to exist before you start making your calls. If it doesn't, then the luck factor is like tenfold. Anyway, I hope this helped you guys. And if you're thinking about being a freight broker, I'll leave you with this. Yes, it is so much hard work at the very beginning. You do have to build up a book of business. It's extremely tough. It's harder than anybody's ever told you. And it's harder than you believe me telling you right now. And it is so worth it. But it's only worth it if you come in with the right mindset, with the right expectations and the right work ethic to make it work for you. Nobody's gonna make it work for you. There's not a company out there. You know, you come over to League and I can get you the best leads that I possibly can. I can get it to a point where, you know, we filtered it out, we pre-qualified, and still you will fail if you don't have the right work ethic. So it doesn't matter where you go, okay? Work ethic comes from you. Is this right for you? Not is a business right for you? Is this company right for you? Is this company right for you? Are you right for this industry? Ask yourself that first and let it scare you. Because you make a mistake and you're not up for the challenge, you're gonna waste 6 months to a year before they let you go or before you quit. One of the two are gonna happen. Are you, I don't wanna say good enough, but do you have the work ethic that is needed? Do you have the family life balance around you that is needed, the support around you that is needed? Do you have the time? Do you have the energy? Is it for you?